Good afternoon to you all. Today is my index presentation day, and firstly I want to welcome all of you to my presentation. My presentation topic is English Communication Course Outline for Call Center Agent. And firstly I want to introduce myself. My name is Rebeka Sultana. I am Woman Call Center Agent, batch number 4. And firstly, I am to discuss a topic and word, that is how our sound made. Different parts of our mouth, which are the lips, tongue, teeth, jaws, hard palate and soft palate. That means our mouth has different parts, and the sound of our have come these parts, and these are lips, tongue, teeth, jaws, soft palate and hard palate, etc. And my second topic is mother tongue influence or MTI. That means MTI is when the sounds of your native language are carried in your native language in your accent. That means we are a Bengali, and so as a Bengali we have accent in your voice, but as a call center agent we have to make our language very proficient. So this MTI is our barrier in our success, so we need to remove this MTI. And my second topic is what is voice. Voice is more to do with the sounds you carry naturally. It is affected by certain factors. That means voice, when we birth, after a year we want to learn the voice, and voice is a natural thing. And voice, there are some topics about voice, and first is pitch. That means when we talk with other people, we need to pitch our voice, the person, very smoothly and carefully. Tone. Every voice has its own tone. When we talk with the customer and other people, we need to talk very clearly with the customer, that customer are easily understand what I am saying. And third topic is rate of speech. That means our speech will be not it is greater and not it is longer or not it is smoother. That means we need to take a balance of our speech. And fourthly is fluency. That means we need to be proficient in our language, and it is to be other language. And there are some points about fluency. And first is reading. That means we want to be proficient about what I am reading, and every topic that I want to read it very smoothly and very professionally. Speaking. And second topic is speaking. We want to speak English very, very smoothly. And listening is very important, that a customer is what say. So customer is whatever say, just I want to listening. And my third topic is communication styles. Communications, there are three types of communication styles, such as first topic is assertive communication styles. That means a positive communication style. It is very good for a communicator, that positive communication, assertive communication style is very good. That means the listener is understand very smoothly through assertive communication. And next is passive communication. Passive communication is not good. That means the listener is not understand what you are saying about passive communication styles. And third is aggressive communication style. Aggressive communication is very dangerous for everyone, because aggressive communication style is, that means very angry communication style. When a customer want to talk with you, your behavior was very aggressive, so your customer will be very angry about you. And aggressive communication have some topics, that is passive aggressive. That means it is a fast stage aggressive. That means aggressive but little aggressive. And second is semi aggressive. That means aggressive is percentage is more like 50%, and active aggressive is very dangerous. that means active aggressive is when a person become active aggressive, he become frustrated with his customer and with others. And our next topic is business etiquette. That means when we business with some other party, other dealer, we need to have some tips and have some qualities such as first of be professional. Firstly, when we work in a professional center, so we need to be professional. If our work is to be very professional. And second is be respectful. We want to be very respectful. When we respect with other, then I also get respect. And third is be honest. In our business, we want to be honest because dishonest man never can shine in his life. So we want to be honest. And next is be confident. That means in our business, I have to be confident in my every step, in my every talk and what I am saying about my customer, about my boss, and that means in every topic I need to be confident. Be neutral. That means I want to be neutral. I want to be neutral in my every work. Be flexible. Be flexible is very good for every man because flexibility is very good. In different circumstances, we need to be flexible. Telephone etiquette. Customers expect professional service when they contact a call center. Proper etiquette should be stressed at every level of a call center business. That means telephone etiquette is very useful for a customer's agent. And there are many topics about telephone etiquette, and first is be polite. That means we want to be polite. When we talk about our customer and our boss, we need to be polite because polite is a nature. It is very good and we want to be polite. And secondly, speak clearly. That means what I am saying, it is very important for me that I can speak very clearly and very smoothly that everyone will easily understand what I am saying. Call management. When a customer call me, I need to hold the call very smoothly, and I tell my customer that some time are available for her or for his, etc. And for this responsiveness, when a customer contact to me, then I need to be responsiveness. Whatever he or she wants from me, I want to responsible for her. Otherwise, she or he very rude to me or very upset to me. And next topic is influential skill. A subtle, empathic approach is recommended rather than a more direct or forceful style. And firstly, we want to create rapport. That means we want to create a good rapport with my customer. So when we build a good rapport with our customer, so our customer will be happy with me and my profession and my job. Listen, whatever if my customer say, I want to listen it very smoothly and I want to realize her that I am listening to her or him. Ask the right questions. If my customer is not understanding anything, so it is my duty that I am asking him or her the questions very effectively as well as very smoothly. Beware of body language. Beware of body language, that means it is very important for me because body language is seems very smoothly that everyone can make me that I am not, my body language is not perfect or etc. Be relaxed. When my customer call me, I want to be relaxed because relaxed mind makes me very perfect. When I was angry, so my customer was very rude at me and she become very frustrated to me. So I want to be relaxed at every moment. Invest your time. Invest your time is very important because lazy persons can never think anything. So I want to invest my time because time and time never wait for none. So It is very important for me that I invest my time. Negotiation skill. Limited time offer. That means when a customer can offer her customer or his customer that it is offer, so you can take it. It's time very limited. So buy one get one free. When any customer cares offer her customer that you can get one and get one free, so her customer or his customer very happy and he or she buy a package about it. Buy a donation. Buy a donation is also a offer that customer cares has offered his customers. Upsell and last topic is freebies. Upsell and last freebies is also a offer when some customer cares is offered to his customers. And my presentation is end, so I want to be thanked to all of you for listening me. Thank you all. Do you have any questions?